Yes. The Lord brought me here in 1997, which is 26 whole years ago. I must have been just 5 then.
15 years.
26 years.
40 years.
Roughly 16 years.
15 years.
4. 26 years.
32 years.
This hours to be 5 years.
13 years.
Since 1987.
Approximately 5 years.
About 11 years.
23 years.
I've been here 48 years.
4 years now.
11 years.
22 years.
12 years.
For 11 wonderful months.
For 7 years.
It's a little bit over a year.
For a little over 10 years now.
6 years?
Per year.
Almost 4 years and over
10 years.
One of my best memories working with the Best Dressed team was working on 50 Fest when we celebrated our 50th anniversary.
Invited to attend the Thanksgiving celebration in Jamaica in 2019.
Robert Levy first came up to visit his new operation in Arkansas, and my dad was here in a wheelchair, and Mr. Robert walked in the front door and put his hand on my dad's shoulder and prayed for him. And I'll always remember that and cherish that memory.
Take a trip to Jamaica with my teammates to meet everybody there and to train for a week. And that was a wonderful opportunity. I got to meet everybody that I work with to this day.
I was about 18 years old, starting out my internship, and Mr. Robert Levy gave me a project. Mr. Levy was very hands-on and I would have follow-up meetings. And in one meeting, he was asking how it's going, and I didn't have anything. And he looked at me and said, "No, man, you have to do something." So, I mean, it kicked me in the butt to get moving. And it's just a start. Once you start, you never know what can happen.
Being a part of the team involved in acquiring and refocusing the Best Dressed Chicken South Carolina plant. And now, seeing the Best Dressed Chicken product alongside other major brands in Dar's Supermarket in Florida is just amazing.
People from the highest levels of the organization and the lowest levels to come together to do one common task, and it really did emphasize that really and truly we are better together. We are best together.
First met Mr. Robert Levy. He had come to visit the mill the first time, and I just had never met a man that was that humble and down to earth. And one of the things he asked is, he said, "Do we mind if we all pray together?" And that really touched me.
I mean, you get enveloped in the whole aspect of what the company is all about.
I was truly blessed to be a part of the groundbreaking embryo program, which was led by Dr. Michael Moto and Mr. Norman Williams.
Management retreat back in Jamaica in 2019. We felt like it was like a family reunion, and then people came from all the different departments.
I have a lot of people in my corner, and it's because of working here with them.
Are the ones that we put on for our customers.
One year we had a paintball competition, and that was very fun. We got to interact with people from different departments who wouldn't normally see, and it was just an overall fun experience.
I wish that Jamaica Broilers will remain true to the core and true to its values.
Family oriented, putting God first, giving back to your community.
Being here to tell you happy 100th.
Just to wish that God continues to bless this company.
Continued growth and profitability.
We've seen a lot of changes for the better, and just looking forward to more.
To grow in the big town and rise in Arkansas.
I think that my wish for the company is just to see it continue to grow and
one of the top players in the U.S. poultry industry.
Continue to touch the lives of everyone.
To be a beacon of light in a world of darkness.
Our leadership continues to provide us with opportunity.
Continues to find favor in the eyes of the Lord.
I wouldn't mind if I did have 20 more years with Jamaica Broilers.
Continue to form new relationships and just improve on what we've built so far.
I'm most grateful for the Christian atmosphere that Wincorp provides for all of its locations.
I can just describe working here as a blessing.
Bigger and greater, feeding the customer with the wholesome chicken.
I couldn't have picked a better company to work for.
Generous leaders that make us all feel that we are part of a big and loving family.
I am so grateful to have the opportunity to work with such an amazing group of people, both far and wide.
They came over in my country, not for trying to make a profit, but to change the lives of many different Haitians. and it did certainly change my life.
Going down to my local grocery store and being able to purchase the best dressed chicken here locally.
To be a part of this great company.
Thankful for the opportunity to work at Jamaica Broilers.
I think I'm most grateful for is that the company is a multi-generational company and that how much it really values its people.
Every day when I walk in here, I feel glad that I'm working in this environment.
And the best of what we have to offer is still before us. So I just want to say happy 65th birthday to Jamaica Broilers Group, and let us continue to be best together.
65 years and going strong.
A happy birthday and continue to grow.
Happy 65th birthday.
All the best for at least another 65.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, big up.
Congratulations, JBG, for 65 years of outstanding performance.
Happy birthday.
65 looks good.
I wish you 65 wonderful years that have passed and 65 more years to come.
Just wish the company a happy birthday and many, many years of continued growth.
Happy 65th birthday. You're almost as old as I am.
Big up your nice, clean self. Happy 65, and I am going to be here, even if they have to push me in a wheelchair, when you celebrate the 80th.
Jamaica Broilers to the world.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Jamaica Broilers Group and the Best Dressed Chicken family.
Happy 65th birthday.
God bless to many years.
Happy 65th. Continue to strive for excellence in all that we do.
Wishing you God's richest blessing.
May you live to see many, many, many more years of growth and development, new products, new initiatives as we go forward together in Jesus' name.
First Thessalonians 5 verse 18 says, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Amen. Dana? Give thanks to the Lord, what? For he is, come on man, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Amen.
Dana, the people look pretty, man. They look good.
Yeah, man, them look pretty for true.
See people in them white, in them yellow.
Them best dressed chicken clothes. Nice. We like it. Oh, I forgot. We have some people in the house that we need to welcome, you know.
Okay.
So I want to see all my high pro folks. Yeah, they're in the house.
All right. I want to see all my hatchery folks.
I want to see all my best dressed chicken folks. All around the group.
I want to see all my feed mill folks.
That's still best dressed chicken, Sheldon. That's a lot of best dressed chicken.
Yeah, it is.
What about my international poultry breeders, folks?
Well, remember, IPB Jamaica folks.
Ah, right, excuse here. Me, IPB USA folks.
Yes.
They're in the house. Yeah. Wanna hear on a name, Jamaica Broilers Group office? No, sir. Come again. My Jamaica Broilers Group office, folks. Yeah, that's it. They weren't ready.
Give them another try, man.
Give them another try. One
head
more.
Head office, man. Come on.
My head office, folks. Yeah, see, that was good.
All right.
They do good. All right. Everybody's in the house. We have special guests in the house. If you're a special guest, give me a wave. Welcome. We're so happy to have you guys. You are our special partners, our special vendors. You guys are a part of our Best Dressed Chicken family. Truth?
Yes.
Yes. So guys, we've done our roll call, but I want to let you know, wait a second, did we do a special big up?
We need to do a special big up for the U.S. operations.
U.S. operations team.
Connected online.
In the house and online. Awesome. Oh, guys, here they are. Oh my goodness. Hey, can we get a wave from you guys? Yes, look, oh gosh, they are live. It's so good to see you guys. Let me see, do we have a correspondent on the ground at WinCorp? Do we have a correspondent at WinCorp that can talk to us? Let me see, no? South Carolina? How y'all doing? Look at that. Oh gosh, it's so good to see you guys. See WinCorp clapping there, yeah. Let me see. North Georgia, you want to give us a clap? Yes.
Is that Simone Black?
Crystal Feeds, how you doing? Yeah. South Georgia, how you doing? Yeah. Is that Iowa in the building? Hey, Iowa. We're so excited to see you guys. Who's that down there? Is that IPB? Hey, IPB. We're so excited to see you. And that's Troy's face. Troy is our IT guy over in the US. Big up, Troy. All right, so Sheldon, what's up next on our program?
All right, so we're going to welcome Miss Denise Smith, and she's going to open in prayer for us, and then immediately following her will be our praise and worship team, our best together worship team.
That's right.
Coming to give us high praise.
That's right. Give her a round of applause.
Hallelujah.
All right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to give God thanks for 65 good years, oh, of guidance and commitment and fulfillment. Oh, Father, we just want to give you thanks this evening, Lord. Oh, God, for guiding us. Oh, Lord God, for leading us, Lord God, for your faithfulness, Lord. You have guided us, mighty God, to open a doors of open opportunity, Lord. Lord God, we just give you thanks, Lord, for what you have done over 65 years, mighty God. You have held us strong, Lord. Oh, God, not a minute, mighty God, wasted, oh, God. But, God, your word is the path of the just shining brighter and brighter, Lord. And we give you thanks, Lord. Lord, we glorify your name. Thank you, God. Oh, God, for your hands over the JB group, mighty God. 65 years, mighty God, and going stronger and stronger and stronger. We give you all the glory, Lord. Father God, we thank you, mighty God, for this afternoon, Lord God. For everyone, mighty God, gathered here, Lord. And those who are online, mighty God, or online viewers, oh God. We just want to glorify your name, Lord. Thank you, mighty God, for what you have done. Oh God, you are too faithful to fail. We serve a faithful God. We serve a mighty God. Thank you, God, for your faithfulness, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Your word says, mighty God, according to Proverbs 16, verse 3 says, commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. Lord God, as we go further, Lord God, today is the first day of our fiscal year 2023-2024, Lord. Lord God, we commit it in your hands, Lord. We ask you to hold our hands, Lord. Whatever is committed in your hands, Lord, it will not waste, it will not spoil, Lord. Oh God, as we go, Lord God, we ask you to open doors of opportunity for us, Lord God. Guide us, Lord. God, your words is according to Psalms 32:8. Oh, God, that you will instruct, you will lead, and you will guide, Lord. We ask you for your instruction, mighty God. For all of our team members, oh, God, our managers, our workers, God, irrespective of their position, Lord God. Instruct us, mighty God, as we go, mighty God, in this new fiscal year, Father. We ask you, Lord God, to just hold our hands, Lord. Oh, we will not fail. Oh, Father, we ask you, Lord God, to take us, mighty God. Oh, Lord, to that place that is called here, Lord God. Father, right now again, Lord God, we give you thanks, mighty God, for the team members and your blessings, Lord. Oh, God, of everyone, mighty God, who have worked with us, Lord God, throughout the 65 years and make our contributions, mighty God. Our farmers, mighty God. Our, mighty God, customers, mighty God. Everyone, mighty God, that would have touched, mighty God. Oh, God, the lives of the JB group, mighty God. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord God. If it wasn't for you, God, we wouldn't have been here this evening, oh, Father, to celebrate this, mighty God, this wonderful occasion, mighty God. Oh, God, again, we say thank you, Lord. Lord, for your guidance. Lord God, your faithfulness, Lord. Oh God, we say, Lord God, we know that you are too faithful to fail, Lord. And you are more than enough, Lord. We ask you, God, as we go, Lord, to enlarge our territory, Lord. Enlarge our borders, oh God. Enlarge our course, mighty God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah.
Stand with me, please, as we get ready to go into a time of worship. Look at the person next to you and just say, happy 65. All right, let us give praise to God who is Amen. Worthy of all our praise. We know that nothing we do would be possible without him. So let's lift our voices. Let's sing out loud. Let's celebrate Jesus. Amen. I have a move with this one, yeah? You are the Ancient of Days. Amen.
All right, now, go warm down. When you warm up, how are you moving? If you know the song, you go move with us. To the left, to the right. That's it. Ready. This song is a blessing and honor, glory and power. It's worthy of the song. So you're going to sing along with us. To us.
We're gonna sing your kingdom right now. Sing.
Join us as we sing this song. If you know it, sing along. If you don't, the lyrics are there. So I want to hear you guys sing, because you sound amazing. So let's give those praises to Him. Amen.
You never stop working. You never stop working. You never
Miracle work, promise keeper. Is that who he is to you? No, man. Miracle worker, promise keeper. Is that who he is to you? Hallelujah. Listen, we're having church out here today, you know. We are here to give God thanks and praise for his faithfulness. For how much? 65 years.
Amen.
With
amen,
what?
Amen.
With God's guidance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not true?
Yeah, man.
To God be the... Miss Denise, God bless you, preacher woman, for that rousing prayer. You know, bless you. Thank you. Miss Jessica and the Best Together worship team, thank you for leading us in worship. Hallelujah.
And just in case they missed it, I'm Sheldon Davis.
Oh, yes. I'm Dana Cameron.
And we are your hosts today.
For this auspicious occasion. So thank you guys for being here. You know, you got to see our U.S. team online. We have U.S. team in the house. We have our local operations here. We have our board of directors. Give him a clap. Minister Hill, we're so happy to have you with us. Minister Hill used to be on our board. He's now serving Jamaica. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. We have our farmers. Hi, farmers, all of you. We have customers. We have vendors. Thank you for taking the time to join us in celebrating God's goodness. Amen.
We have a special person to welcome right now.
Who's that? Do he born and grow around chicken?
Yeah. Someone we call him the big boss.
The big boss? Yeah, do you mean like Prezi?
The group. President and CEO.
Please join us in welcoming to the stage Mr. Christopher Levy.
Please turn on. Waymaker. Promise keeper.
That is who you are.
Waymaker.
Miracle worker. Promise keeper. Light in the darkness, my God.
That is who you are. Afternoon, guys. How are y'all doing? I can walk with this. This really looks weird, doesn't it? It's a tremendous honor to be here. 65 years. A few of us here are nearing that. Some have passed it. Some are looking at it in the distance. That's wonderful. You know, I have a little note I want to share with you, but I watched Passion City Church on Sunday. We had to be in the States and Sally and I watched it. And every one of us have a start date, January 27th, 1966. January people. Every one of us also have a dash. And nobody knows what that next date is. And let me tell you, the question the guy asked was, what are you going to do with your dash? When the time comes and you're there, you're going to say, oh, yeah, I read the book of Paul. Paul, so thank you for writing. And it was great. And I especially like this passage. And I can quote the scripture and this and that. And he turns around and says, so what did you do? What did you do with your dash? And it's a very reflective question, guys. And I'm going to tell you one thing I know I'm going to do with my dash. I'm going to tell him thank you. Thank you for how he's blessed us. Thank you for how he has protected us. Thank you for how he has led us. Thank you for the people that he's brought into our lives. And give him the glory over my dash every time I get the honor and opportunity to give him the glory over my dash. When I look at the organization, it's amazing what has happened over the last 65 years. I've probably been involved, I don't know, close to 30 or 40 years. It gets to be a blur after a while. But one thing I've seen a change, and there's a change taking place in our world today with technology. You see, there are three times that God in the world, really and truly intervened in the world. First was with the flood. He intervened. He said, things are off the rails. Flood. Second time, languages and culture. Third time was Jesus Christ. Opportunity. What we're seeing now, ladies and gentlemen, with ChatGPT and artificial intelligence and all of that stuff that none of us really understand, really challenges languages and culture. It brings it to the forefront because all of a sudden it's no longer relevant. We can all talk the same language. Cultures don't really matter because the communications are now seamless. Because it's not even us that's doing it. And it led me to think a little bit and say, what's our language? What's our language in Jamaica Broilers? Is it a language of quality? Is it a language of trust and integrity? Is it a language that builds each other up? What's our language? When people interact with us, what language are they hearing? You go somewhere like DR or you go Panama, you're hearing Spanish. What language are they hearing when they interact with us? Each one of us. What's our language? Is it one that glorifies or one that tears down? Is it one of thanksgiving or one of arrogance that we're owed and deserve? What's our language? And as we move into this year, this new financial year, I want to urge us to be very, very aware of our language. How do we interact with each other? How do we communicate with customers? How do we communicate with suppliers, colleagues? What's our language? Every year we try and do this, and we do it, and it's great. But I'm going to tell you something I feel in my heart, that this is the most important year. This is the most important year we've gathered to say thank you. And we need to recognize that all the world that's changing around us and swirling, and there's a lot more questions than answers. We need to recognize that the one constant that we have, the one constant that we have, Waymaker, miracle worker, light in the darkness, my God, that's the one thing we have, guys. Our Waymaker, light in the darkness, miracle worker, our God. And today, we pause to tell our God, our miracle worker, our light in the darkness that's around us, thank you. This is not about a celebration of Jamaica Broilers. It's not. It's not about a celebration of the amazing success that we've had. It's a pause. Like when he healed the lepers and one came back and said, thank you. We want to be the one that he says, where's everybody else? I see you, but where's everybody else? I say, boy, Lord, I don't know you, but I'm here. I'm here. So it's a heart of gratitude we want. So as we go into this afternoon, and it's a little warm, but that's all right. As we go into this afternoon, I want us all to be aware of our language. And I want us all to be very, very aware of the fact that we're here to tell him thank you. We make a miracle worker, light in the darkness, promise. My God, that is who you are. Amen. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you, President Christopher Levy. Indeed, he is all we have. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. We just want to welcome Mr. Michael Hanna now. He will be reading for us from the Word of God. Mr. Michael Hanna is the Vice President of Finance at Wincorp International.
Our scripture reading is from the book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verses 1 through 9. To humans belong the plans of the heart, but from the Lord comes the proper answer of the tongue. All a person's ways seem pure to them, but motives are weighed by the Lord. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. The Lord works out everything to its proper end, even the wicked for a day of disaster. The Lord detests all the proud of heart. Be sure of this, they will not go unpunished. Through love and faithfulness, sin is atoned for. Through the fear of the Lord, evil is avoided. When the Lord takes pleasure in anyone's way, he causes their enemies to make peace with them. Better a little with righteousness than much gain with injustice. In their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps. My colleagues and friends, what a joy it is to know that when we commit our ways and plans to our Heavenly Father, we can trust in His abundant love, that through His mighty power and for His glory, He will lead us, guide us, and establish our steps. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Who establishes the work of our hands? The Lord God. We're just going to invite our worship team back to the stage, and we're going to teach you a quick song talking about how he has established the work of our hands as the Best Dressed Chicken family. So I want you to just listen, stand with us, sing with us. It's easy peasy. I'm going to turn over to our team. I'm going to jam with them for a bit. The Best Dressed Chicken 65th anniversary. Sing with us.
Oh,
the name of the Lord.
Lord, that you are responsible for all of it, Jesus. And so we give all the glory to you, Lord. And we exalt your name in this place. As we go into this next part of worship, please just continue to stand with us and sing along as we sing, Wide as the Sky.
We lift you high.
Jesus, we lift you high.
We sing.
Worship the Lord if you know that God has been good.
Amen.
If you know the goodness of God, let's worship God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're here to celebrate His goodness. He is faithful, unchanging, unshakable. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
still sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
Is that your testimony?
All my life you have been so.
For my overseas guests, I just want to say, when we are just surprised and marveling at God's goodness, this is what we say. What a way, God, good. That's how we say it in Jamaica. Let me hear you try it. What a way, God, good. Yeah, man, same so. Yeah. All right. So now you're one of us. You belong. Sheldon, I want to give these people some gifts because, I mean, I just think they're amazing.
Yeah, man.
You think so?
Start off with some easy,
easy things.
Questions.
Let me tell you, this company was founded a long time ago. Who can tell me when 65 years began? You have to come. You have to come. You can't shout it out. Me can't see you.
All right.
You have to come to the stage. I can't see you.
I think that looks like Miss Yvonne from the hatchery.
Ah, come.
1958.
1958.
Bigger up.
All right, and just a slight disclaimer. If you're a member of the board of executives,
they can't play.
Board of directors, can't play.
They can't play?
Can't play.
Oh.
Immediate disqualification.
Oh, no. Well, I have a different prize for them then. I forgot to sort out something.
Maybe later.
All right, okay.
All right, let me try one. Let me try one. All right, so you guys saw the praise team.
Ooh.
So there were a couple persons on the praise team from Jamaica Broilers Group Limited.
Yep.
We want one person, first row of hands, to give us the full name of two.
Come on. Come on,
full name of two persons on the praise team from Jamaica Broilers Group Limited.
We'll give, come, I see Narika, you know, I see your shout out. Come man, don't shy. Come to the stage, Narika. That's my best US accent. I'm trying. You have to teach me something. Who else is going to try? Narika is going to give us one. Can somebody else give us another one?
No, I tried to give us two.
No, oh, yeah, go so hard.
She stood up for two.
You're being so difficult.
Oi, sir, give her for two or for one?
Two.
Ah, crowd says it, two.
Tell us who you know on the worship team.
Kirk Michael Ars.
Kirk Michael, could you stand up, please?
Who just happens to be at Hypro, the same place she works. Should we allow it?
Miss Narika, congratulations. Give somebody else a prize, man.
All right, so somebody else. So we'll make it easy now, so one.
Come.
Miss Trisha Murray
Roper, you say. Show me her. Which one is she? The one in the yellow. Stand up, Miss Trisha.
Congratulations.
Now, there is one more, you know, Sheldon.
We have one more.
Somebody name never call. I wonder if anybody, see somebody hand up there. Who knows the other member of the Jamaica Broilers group who sings on the Best Together worship team? See, she'll come in or she come. Ready.
Miss Lakeva Brown.
Miss Lakeva Brown, jump up. Show us yourself. Awesome. Bless you guys. We have such a talented team here. The Best Dress family. And we're just excited to have all of you be a part of this service. Not true, Sheldon?
Definitely.
Yeah, man.
Without further ado. This distinguished gentleman.
Easy now.
Will be sharing God's word with us today. Mr. Robert Levy. He joined the Jamaica Broilers Group in 1959, just 1 year after its inception.
Wow.
Throughout his over 60 years working in various capacities within the company, he was appointed as CEO in 1994. He was appointed president and CEO in 2001. And now in his current position as chairman of the board of directors since 2009. You know anything else about this distinguished man?
I do. Let me tell you, he's long-standing service across the agriculture industry, a crop expert, a livestock expert, multiple accolades across private sector Jamaica, and national honors too. A very distinguished gentleman indeed. Let me tell you too, a champion of the youth, right? A community builder. An evangelist, you ever hear him talk about God? Let me tell you, you better know. And also, he just loves the Lord deeply and is such a humble gentleman. Not true?
Let us welcome the Honorable
Robert Levy. Want to know something though? Mr. Levy, we didn't forget. It's your birthday. So we're going to give him Jamaican style. One, two, three, four.
Happy birthday to you, dear chairman.
Happy birthday. Sing the chorus.
Happy birthday.
One more time.
Happy birthday to you, dear chairman.
Happy birthday.
Good, thank you very much. Before I start, a good friend,
He's a good, good friend. Left cabinet and came out here. He said he told the Prime Minister, I've just gone for an hour. And the hour has far exceeded its time. Minister Hill, thank you for coming so much. You're a good friend. He was a board director. He led us through such important times. And we know you have to leave. So let's give him a big hand. This morning, my daughter phoned me and she said, Dad, I know you're going to do the best thing that you want to do. Mondays is usually my golf day, right? But I said, yes, Amanda. She said, yes, you're going to address Jamaica Broilers on your birthday. And I just thank the president for giving me such an honor to be able to share today on my 83rd birthday. I hope that as I share, I really hope that as I share, right? I've said this to so many. I pray that you may understand and see what the Lord Jesus Christ did in my life and what the Lord Jesus Christ, we are saying, thankful for, has done in this company. I want you to hear this. Hear this carefully. Jamaica Broilers is the largest poultry operation in Jamaica, in the Caribbean and Central America. It produces close to 6 million hatching eggs a week. It produces close to 7 million pounds of chicken meat each week. The company has the largest farm store in the whole Caribbean. It has operations, listen carefully, it has operations in Jamaica, Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, Arkansas, Iowa, Pennsylvania, and the best dressed chicken is produced and sold in the United States of America. We must can give the Lord a hand. I was born on the 1st of May in 1940. I was born with what is called dyslexia. That's a learning disability. But it doesn't only affect learning, it also affects reasoning. You can't reason properly. At 2 years old, I sat beside my mother's bicycle, at 2 years old, turning the pedal, put my finger into the chain, and I cut it off. How foolish. At 20 years old, I was installing a chicken feeder, and the chain got stuck. And again, lack of reasoning, I put my hands into the chain to release it, and guess what? Two fingers. But ladies and gentlemen, God wanted me to carry those two fingers with me for the rest of my life. Because he wanted me never to forget what a terrible, filthy guy I was. And I'll talk about that. My father was one of five brothers. They had an import business in Kingston called Levy Brothers Limited. They imported medical supplies and they also imported food supplies. He traveled a lot. And during the 50s, he was traveling to the States and he saw in the States fresh poultry being sold. Plucked fresh poultry. None like that had ever been seen in Jamaica. The only time we had chicken was when mama or somebody would go to the market, buy a brown fowl, take it home, feed it for 2 days or so, and on Sundays, the gardener would take it, put it under a wash pan, cut off its head, and you'd hear the most unbelievable flapping under the pan. The sport of my brother and myself was to go and kick over the pan. And you would see the headless chicken running all over the yard. And that was what we had. Levy Brothers Limited started to import fresh processed chicken in the 50s. There was one meat market, and it was owned by Mr. Byron Coombs. and he had a cold storage down at Bond Street in Kingston. The exporter of the chicken, Mr. Larry Udell, talked to my dad and Byron Coombs about setting up an operation in Jamaica to commercially produce chicken. Nothing like that had ever been done. Dad could not convince his brothers, and the three partners could not convince any farmers to put up a chicken house. So the three of them put up £5,000 each, and it got started. My sister got married to a Dr. David Wildish. His father was a great evangelist, English evangelist that has ever come to Jamaica. Between the 40s and 70s, he started 12 Brethren churches. Amazing, they're still growing. And that was the first introduction of true Christianity that the Levis ever experienced. Dr. Wildish's brother, Mr. Andy Wildish, was the first employee. And as much as the three founders invested their money, Andy Wildish invested his life. And I stand here today to tell you that Andy Wildish laid the foundations of Jamaica Brawlers. And this is what we're built on. I recognize him as one of the heroes of the past. I wish I had time to really tell about him. I joined Jamaica Brawlers when I was 18 years old. After leaving school at 15, never finished high school at all. And between 15 and 18, I gave so much trouble that my father figured if he put me under Andy Wildish, I'd have a chance. The first chicken house was put up at Spring Village. It was to hold 3,000 chickens. The first shipment of baby chicks that came to the island, I think, was 500 chickens. I remember back in those days at the back of Mr. Coombs Cold Storage, which I said was in downtown Kingston on Bond Street, we would process 50 chickens a day. We would dip them in boiling water and we would hand pick them. Ladies and gentlemen, that is how this company started. Again, it could take the whole afternoon to tell you some of the great stories of those early days. Andy convinced some farmers in the St. Mary area, the Bob Walk area, and all the way out to Maypen to put up some chicken houses. We would meet the plane with baby chicks at the airport, get them down on the farm. We'd visit each farm twice a week. We would catch chickens at night. We would help at the small kill plant that was built at Spring Village. And then Mr. Mike Jones, I saw him there, we would do some marketing, right? It was full time. Remember now, the only chicken that Jamaica knew was what is called a brown fowl or peel neck fowl. Anybody knows what a peel neck fowl is? Well, that's surprising because I thought we had eradicated all the peel neck fowl around. But I know the Americans don't know what peel neck fowl is. Right, Americans? You don't know what peel neck fowl is? No. Peel neck fowl is an unbelievable strong chicken that is grown, and there are absolutely no feathers on the head or neck, and it tastes tough. So nobody knew about white fowl, which we were producing. So every Saturday night at our head office on Hope Road, we would put on an all-you-can-eat for one price. And boy, did the chicken start to take off. In the 60s, JB was established itself as one of the agribusiness. We started producing table eggs. We entered into a joint venture to build a feed mill. And the kill plant at the out of Spring Village was really upgraded to a processing plant. In 1964, the most beautiful girl in Jamaica, the most beautiful girl in the world agreed to marry me. I really don't know how come. Because believe me, I was not that pleasant. I carried a gun. I cussed more bad words than you could possibly imagine. I was terrible. But I remember those old early days, and she was very special. Sometimes after coming home in the afternoon, I had to go back out to catch chickens, and Judy would drive so I could sleep. How wonderful. In 1970, in my arrogance and foolishness, I had a quarrel with my dad, and I told him I was going to leave the company. Again, what a fool. Can you imagine? I had dropped out of school at 15. I had no education whatsoever. The salary belonged to the company. The house belonged to the company. The cars belonged to the company. I was disturbed in my heart as to my future. I was married to Judy, and we had two children. The days before I left, I would go and sit in Halfway Tree Parish Church, and I would beg God to give me a peace in my heart. And he never answered me. The day I was leaving, I locked my office door, ladies and gentlemen, and I said, I'm not coming out of here till I hear from God. And it was just as if I saw him on the wall of my office up in the corner. He said, Robert, how can I have anything to do with your life unless it belongs to me? And right there in my office, I knelt on my knees and I said, Lord, I don't know where this human body is going to go, but today I want to just put it into your care. Something happened spiritually. I can't explain it. I'm not sure that I fully know, but I know that somehow, spiritually, I had met God. I left that day, right, and some godly, wonderful Christian men gathered around me, and they started me reading the Bible. Now, with dyslexia, that was a problem, but I started reading the Bible. And God wonderfully started to change my life. We had moved to Mandeville. And I can tell you, in Mandeville, our lives changed as God's word came into my life. And I learned for the first time that Jesus Christ had paid for my sin. That was something that registered deep down, that I knew in my heart the filth that was in this body, Jesus Christ had paid the price. And I could have a relationship with the living God. Yeah, let's give him a hand. Listen, God did some wonders. In Mandeville, nobody knew the situations we were in. And I can tell you here this afternoon that we ran out of food and God fed us. We changed in such an amazing way that we're never ever the same. I was sharing this with somebody and they said, well, how did you get back into Jamaica Brawlers? So in 1974, the executives asked me to help them with a contract to build a poultry breeders operation up in St. Anne. That's to produce hatching eggs. Now, they want to come off with 300,000 hatching eggs every single week. Those people in the chicken business realize to come off with the same amount of eggs every week, you have to really schedule what you're doing. So I had big graph papers, and I'd write down the schedules of when the chickens, the new flocks go in, when the old flocks come out, and it was an immense amount of calculation. A friend of mine told me that there was a thing called a personal computer. And it was about this size. And it was a program called VisiCalc. This was a program written in Japan and translated into English. And here was a young man that had dyslexia, that couldn't read. Can you imagine trying to figure out a Japanese program written into English? I was getting nowhere. Mrs. Levy and myself took ourselves and we went up into Newcastle area. And I prayed and asked God to open my mind. And there's a passage in Corinthians and it says, where is the wise, where is the prudent of this girl? This world, hasn't God put to naught the wisdom of man? And I start to understand God has wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, God opened my mind in that program that I was able to make the calculations of the whole. But more than that, I was able to make calculations for the company, financial projections. All of the guys had never done a five-year projection, and if they had one change, boop, touch one thing, whoop, and it changed. Nothing like this. Of course, guess what? They asked me to join back the company. Right? And then, guess what? It wasn't long before I became a manager. It wasn't long before I became an assistant general manager. It wasn't long before I became president. So God brought this about in the most marvelous way. And we thank him. I want to say, you know, no company in Jamaica has gone through more agricultural ventures than Jamaica Brawlers. I promise you. Listen to me. We did vegetables in the 60s. We had plane loads of vegetables going to the United States. We thought we would be multimillionaires on vegetables. And then the vegetables in California came out and started to come into the United States, into the East Coast. And guess what? They stopped buying our vegetables. Right? We had over 10,000 goats at Goat Island. That phased out. We did fish in the 90s. Oh boy, every one of us went through the fish business. We did feedlot cattle, we did fertilizer, we did corn. We even tried banking. Yeah, who fails at banking? But by far, our biggest one-time venture was ethanol. In 2005, ethanol, let me just explain, ethanol is a very pure alcohol made from sugar cane. And in the early 2000s, it became the hottest thing to add to gasoline, especially in the United States. Brazil, being the largest producers of sugar cane, were also the largest producers of ethanol. And us having all of our imports coming over Port Escobar, we figured this is a fit. Let us put up a facility in Port Escobar, and we can import it, we can refine it, and we can send it into the United States duty-free. Oh boy, the chicken business was secondhand. Well, we asked, the directors asked Mr. Chris, no, the executives and directors asked Mr. Chris Levy to do the project. He's sitting there, Sally put his, just cock him ears a little bit for me. But his performance was so outstanding. He produced the operation in record time and under the budgeted figure. Well, what do you think happened? He was a natural successor as president, right? And therefore, he came in as the new president. Let's give him a hand. One of his major decisions was that we should stick to chicken, only chicken, not looking left or right, but only chicken. In keeping with that decision, he not only looked to Jamaica, but had a vision for the US. And when his young brother, Mr. Stephen Levy, graduated from college, he decided he should stay, that he should keep him in the United States and develop the small business of hatching eggs that we had. Of course, my mother, my wife and myself were dead against this. We already had our two daughters live in the States. Now we're going to have three of our children live in the States. No way. But he pushed through. Well, any young man coming out of college is not satisfied with the status quo. And this young man talked us into a significant expansion. We all said, where are you going to sell the eggs? What are you going to do? But he prevailed. As soon as the eggs started to be produced, Mexico had one of the largest breakdowns in their breeder flocks. And eggs, hatching eggs, went from $2 to $6 a dozen. What do you think? He was now the star boy, right? And he's here with us today, and we thank him. Now, again, do we say that was that luck or was that the graciousness of God? Today we're saying, thank you, Lord. We're not here to thank Mr. Lucky. I shared at the start the wonder of this liquor company having operations in six states in the United States. There are many here today from the U.S. and also watching online. And I can tell you that our president has unbelievable plans for you. As I wrap up, there are some heroes of the past that I must mention. It's just a sample. And as at the start, we saw some of them. And I just mentioned some. Believe me, there are many, many. I could go on for an hour. But I want to just mention Trevor Dudney, Richard Broderick, Noel Wong, Keith Howell, that's a trucker, Sheila Carmichael, Dougie Sr., another trucker, Carlton Levy, Errol Simons, Delrose Hemming. There are also two directors that I feel have been with us for over 20 years, and I have to put them in the category of heroes. The first is Dr. Claudette Cook, a woman of great value. Of great value to Jesus and to Jamaica Broilers. And she's here today. Claudette, would you stand? Thank you, Cece. The other is the Honorable Danny Williams. Unfortunately, he's not able to come, but I know he's online, him and Mrs. Williams. But let me tell you about Danny first. He has received more business awards of any business leader I know. But much more than that, he has held the respect of every businessman. I have never heard or seen in writing any negative comments about Danny Williams. That's awesome. And he is an outstanding man, and God led him into this company as a director for all the last 20 years. He also acted as chairman for a while. Let's give him a wonderful big hand. I know that Dad, in his wildest imagination, could not imagine today. So I will not try to think what the Lord has in store for all of you. I won't try and go there, because I know as far as Dad thought, he could not think. So 20 years or 5 years or 10 years, I have no idea. As to myself, at 83, you have to be thinking of the end. Well, our president wrote on the tail of our company plane, John 3:16. It's a Bible verse. Can you imagine a Bible verse on a chicken plane? When we land at the airport, some of the ground staff would say, is which preacher that? And the pilots would say, no, they're tricking people. I said, what? Tricking people? With a Bible verse. But he wrote it, and that Bible verse says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. You remember I shared earlier, I believe he paid for all my sin. I know when that final day comes, I will be in heaven because of what he did. And I will look on him, and when I look at him, I will marvel, because I'll have perfect hands. The fingers will be restored. I won't need glasses. But when I look at him, I will see the marks of the cross, the price he paid for my sin. And of course, I will praise him. Before I sit down, I ask that we would just sing a blessing. And our precious lady here is to sing a blessing for us.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you. He is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you. He is for you. For you, he is 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 for you.
Amen.
Amen. Jessica, thank you very much. Before I sit down, you know, I would love to pray. I'd love to pray for you. And there might be some of you that you felt the Lord talking to you today is something I said. And we're not talking about here, Jamaica Broad, we're talking about individually. Because as a company, we're made up of individuals. And if you'd like me to pray for you, I'd love you to just stick up your hand and just say, Lord, pray for me. Just ask the Lord to be with me. Yeah, I said, praise the Lord. I just love to pray for those that feel that they need prayer. Amen. Amen. Lord Jesus, we just think of your word going out today. Not Robert Levy, but your graciousness in his life and in this company. We think as it goes out, Lord, that you have spoken to the hearts of some. We pray that it would be concreted and they would come to know you as a giving God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Chairman. Thank you so much for bringing God's word. Amen. Such a privilege to hear his testimony through the ages. Thank you, Chairman. We're going to invite Paul to come and just pray with us
over this company. There's so much happening here in Jamaica. We know our hatchery out at Cumberland is being worked on. We know we have expansion plans across the United States. We are excited about everything that God is doing with us and for us. And we just want to give God thanks. And we want to, with God's guidance, commit everything, not true, Paul, to the Lord's hands. So would Paul just lead us in a prayer at this time?
Bless the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. I know the time is far spent. As I sat and listened to all what was done here today, it's indeed a blessing. God is amazing. And truly, He must be praised. If our moderator would allow me for a minute or so, I just want to acknowledge our chairman, his family, president, his family, all the board members, family, all the managers here and abroad, fellow co-workers, everyone that are here, customers, friends, I greet you today in the holy name of Jesus. It is a sweet spirit hovering in this place. And we know who that spirit is. It's none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. Sweet Holy Spirit. Sweet Heavenly Dove. Right here with us, fill us with your love. And for each blessing, we lift our hearts in praise. Be thou. That we have been revived, when we shall leave this land. 65 years being a long time. And I listened to our president, and I take note, he said, of all the years of Thanksgiving, this year is the most important year. The man after God's own heart, David, he wrote Psalm 65. And I want to dedicate it to Jamaica Boilers Group today. He said, praise waited for thee, O God, in Zion, and unto thee shall the vow be performed. O thou that hearest prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. Iniquities prevail against me. As for our transgression, thou shalt purge them away. Blessed is the man whom thou choosest, and causest to approach unto thee, that he may dwell in thy courts. We shall be satisfied with the goodness of thy house, even of the holy temple. Today, I want to pray and also give a word. I am not a prophet, but I believe in one who knows all things. But the Lord has laid something on my heart. As I was praying in October 1st of October, 2022, in early morning as it was praying. But so first I want to pray for us, for unity among our staff and team members. If Jamaica Boilers Group will go further and to accomplish what the Lord already established, then we have to be united. So we're going to pray for unity. Can we stand up, please? Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. You who have set thy glory above the heavens, out of the mouth of babes and suckling thou art ordained strength to still the enemy and the avenger. Lord, we come to you today with grateful hearts. The Jamaica Boilers family, here on this plot of ground and even on the social media, the platform. We come, Lord, because we recognize everything that you have done. It's not about our wisdom. It's not about who we are, but it's all about who you are. And so, Lord, you have shown yourself mighty and glorious. Throughout the years, 65 years, where this company, Jamaica Boilers Group, has been growing from strength into strength. And so, Lord, we pray today for the community, Lord, of Jamaica Boilers Group, that community feeling and togetherness one more time. We pray, Lord, you said, how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And so, Lord, as we unite our mind, our forces, our thoughts, and, oh God, the main ingredient of unity is the word faith. If we could ever believe what you are about to do and already done, then, Lord, this company shall and will ever be a great force to reckon with. So I pray a special blessing on every member of Jamaica Boilers Group, wherever they are, that as we unite and follow the leadership, the faith, Lord, the vision of what you have placed in his heart, then, Lord, we shall all be rejoicing and be glad that we, at some point in time, were associated with Jamaica Boilers Group. Lord, sit on us today. Breathe on us, Holy Ghost. Let your divine will and purpose manifest through faith. Demonstrate your power. Be glorious individually and collectively as a family, a community. Bless us here today, God. And let this unity be such, oh God, not only at work, but it will spill over in our homes, in our communities. And we, as the Jamaica family, will make a great change in our country. Bless us, Lord, even now, in Jesus' name. We want to pray for the operation at the Cumberland Hatchery. The Lord knows what is happening. The Lord knows the vision, and it's already enacted for success. Father, I pray. You know the challenges, Lord, that this hatchery face at this moment. But the vision, the seed of sown already to be manifest, we declare victory over this operation. No weapon that form against it shall prosper. In every tongue that rise up, we condemn it now in Jesus' name. It shall arise and be a rising star. Yashama, kotoliketema, shanda ukoni, leshanda akotolinga, manumuisha. You watch over your word, Lord, to perform it. And it is done in Jesus' name. I'm going to ask in this last prayer of intercession, I'm going to ask our president and our chairman to join me, please, sir. Sirs, I am touched by your testimony. And also, I am touched by our president's comment earlier on. I do not claim to be anybody. I'm not trying to impress you, sir. I'm not trying to big up myself. But on October 1, last year, I was praying. And I must make it public that every Monday morning, my telesales and I, Leonie Alert, we pray for the company. Every Monday morning. And while I was praying that morning, early in the morning, about 3 o'clock, I believe, a word came in my spirit. And I wrote it down in my phone. And I said to myself, Lord, I have no way in my simple mind to have a conversation with Mr. Levy. So how am I going to tell him this?
In front of everybody.
And so I prayed and I just leave it. Last year, I was asked to do, because I'm not somebody who try to be always pushing myself. I normally stay quiet and do my thing in secret. But I asked to pray the opening prayer last year. And the Lord gave a word. As I was praying, he said, Jamaica Boilers Group not only going to be a national company, not only going to be an international company, but a global company. And so the Lord said to me, write this down. And they need to know that globality begins in the United States of America, in the city of Colorado. I don't even know where that is. So as we're going to pray for expansion in the U.S. operation, the expansion in the vision serves, especially President Levy, that the Lord has placed in the heart. The Lord wants you to know from, you know, it's not me telling you, it just happened that you want, I'm here. Because when I was called by Sister Lauren to do this prayer, I said, God, you're amazing. I get the opportunity to tell you, sir. And the Lord wants you to know that the vision and the things that you're praying, the ideas that even you share, that persons think, thought you're crazy, is already established. He wants you to remember Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 2 and 3. The vision was already sown. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. And so the Lord is saying, Sir Levy, he makes some statement that frightened me about maybe, you know, you don't have know how much time you have. But just in case, if you don't live to see it, you've heard it.
I live what?
If you don't live to see what I'm saying now, you've heard it. But Jamaica Boilers Group is a global company. The Lord said, it's not because of any ingenious thing, it's because of the commitment that you have placed, the seed of faith that you have demonstrated, is going to make your vision bigger than yourself. So, today, as we pray for expansion in the U.S. operation, I said it, if you're going to forget it, write down the vision. Let all men be liars, include me, and God be true. Amen. Expansion begins. Globality begins in Colorado. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for our chairman, the vision that you have placed in his heart, the seed of faith. Faith in his acronym means full assurance in the heart. And as he has trusted you over these years, and you have demonstrated your faithfulness to him based on his trust in you, Lord, today, from the 1st of October 2022, is 7 months, the first day of May, the birthday of our chairman. You have established a word, and you watch over your word, and it shall come to pass. Lord, I pray today that this seed of faith, there's nothing can stop it. As they enlarge their borders and strengthen their stakes, this company shall be a force to reckoning with. I see victory. Lord, we see your hands already perform it. And it is done in the name of Jesus. I pray for a special blessing upon the Levis family and generation to come. I pray for all our board members, executive, all our managers here and abroad, workers, associate, Lord, that as you continue to bless us, Lord, to be a family, a community of faith, let this vision be alive in all of us. Everything that we do, everything that we say, must be a part of the accomplishment of this vision. I pray for our president, that you continue to inspire him, Lord. You know those moments, Lord, when he comes to you and pours out his heart to you. And maybe, Lord, he may not realize that you hear, but today, Lord, the vision that is in his heart shall manifest, and nothing shall stop it. I pray for all our managers, my fellow co-workers, that you continue to bless us individually and our families. And as we work together in unity, Lord, Lord, we pray the Jamaica Boilers Group will go from strength to strength. Oh, Lord, I feel the victory. Because the vision, Yashakatama Atenolu, Setengo Mahando Koshana Yama, Iketendo Lasinge Maha Otunumi, Lingamahatundu Mashi Yasanama Ikotundu, Mena Yeketia Etunuma Ishana, Leni Kotun Mosha, Mea Katone Asibo Ai Kanungo Shua. In Jesus' name. Let us say in Jesus' name. Just before you go, sir, I want to do one more thing. Sorry to take up so much time. I said before, I just have to do what the Lord laid at my heart. And if I don't do it, then I'm in trouble. And I don't need no accolades for this. I just want to do what the Lord laid at my heart. Now, Jesus is here. And he wants all of us to know that he is the reason why we are here. He's the reason why we live. So I can't leave without leave the priest's blessing upon us all. Can you raise your right hand, please? All of us, the Lord Jesus Christ bless thee and keep thee. The Lord Jesus Christ make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord Jesus Christ lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Amen. Receive the peace of the Lord in Jesus' name. When I say amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's congratulate the Lord for such an amazing word. God is good all the time. God is good all the time. Hallelujah. Yeah? We want to just let you know that as we recognize the Spirit of the Lord is among us, we also recognize that you are physically among us and will need a little something. So for our special guests who have a gold armband, after the service, we invite you to this side. And to our team members, our JBG family, we have a host of options for you on this side. And that will ensure that everybody is served quickly. All right? Your armband is what will get you that delicious something to keep the physique up. You know what I'm saying? So bless the Lord for all the spiritual things that are happening here today. We are so grateful for the worship, for the prayer, for the word. Are you excited about what God is doing? Yeah, man, I'm excited. Are you excited, Sheldon?
Definitely. Expansion.
Expansion. Growth. Yeah. God's grace. His name exalted above the nations.
Yes.
Yeah, man. So what else do we have for these people today?
They're still here. We have a guest singer here, you know.
We have a guest.
Yeah, man.
Okay. Y'all ready for more singing or not? Yeah? You sure? Or we must just tell the guest nobody. It's all right.
You know, the best way to introduce this person, you know.
Okay, them say them want him, you know.
The best way to introduce this person.
The best way.
Is for us to bust a tune. What you say?
Who bust what?
We.
Anybody can testify whether Sheldon can sing? Oh, I have one person clapping. So we're going to give Sheldon a chance.
No, man. All right. No. We're co-hosting this thing.
We are co-hosting.
So, yeah,
so I am to sing with you. Lord, be with us. All right. Let's see how this goes.
Come on.
These people know who's in the house today.
We're going to tell them.
One, two, three, four.
Welcome, Kevin Downswell.
To the best dressed chicken.
We're going to introduce the people.
65 years. Sing along.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm not afraid.
Sing it if you know it.
My shepherd, he walks beside me all the way.
I will not fear. No, God is there. Pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up. Oh. But no, Kevin knows that I hear me, you know. So, not going to keep it going.
No.
Might get in trouble, so
yeah, we have
how
a different job.
Yeah, man. We
you hear that?
How
hear that?
You do? Kevin knows well.
Kevin knows
how
well.
You do. Okay. Good evening, everybody. Hey, close your eyes. It's okay. Take a step. What's up, family? Try everybody on your feet. Let's go. I see your light. Hey, give me some volume on the track. Don't let your light go out. Hey, don't let your light go out. Hands up. I see your hands up like this. Hey, don't let your light. Give me the track. Give me the track. Give me the track. Give me the monitor, so. Hey, darkness. Can't understand why JB still breathing after all they've done. Hey, 'cause greater is he that's within you than the kingdoms of this world. Oh, you're bigger, you're greater, JB, JB. Everybody, hands up like this, say, I see your light. No. Don't let your light go. Don't let your light go. I see your light. I know the season we're in. It's a rough season, but this is my challenge. This is my challenge. Hey, if you're a warrior, hands up. If you're a victor, hands up. You're a survivor. If you're more than a conqueror, hey, if you're a miracle,
God is with you. Shout, fighting for you. Cause it's me, Kevin. Let me bring the band in. And so that is, say, I see your light. Say, shine, cut the track for me, Kevin. Right here, you say, I see your light. Everybody over there, so what's going on over there, sir? I want to see the hands in my hands up over there, sir. No, Lord, no, chorus one more time, say, I see your light, hey, shining. Don't let your light go. Do something for me. Turn to the person beside you for me. Look in them face. Hold on for them hand. Give them a smile. Say what I want. Look on them face. Look on them face. Now look on them. Say, I see your light. Say, shining. Don't let your light touch your neighbor, no man. Touch your neighbor. Say, I see your. Don't let your light go. Say, I see your. Look a lot of quiet. Sing, say. Don't let your. Say, don't let your light go. Hey, I see your. Ooh, don't let your light go, Kevin. Somebody shout hallelujah. Kevin, run it for me. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody stretch your hand and say, Father, carry me. Hey. Bring the truck up for me now, bro. Somebody shout hallelujah. When the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and I can't see clearly, I will lift my eyes to the hills from whence my command. My help it comes from who? Come the JB. Lead me on, lead me on. Hey, where I've never been before. That's my prayer for you guys. Now everybody put your hands up. Say, when I come. Louder than that, say, Father. Up, pull that up. Somebody stretch and shout hallelujah. Say, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. We love you, Father. Here we go. Say, when the and heavy, when it's dark, when it's dark, and I can't see clearly. I will the hills from where's my command. My help it comes from Jesus. You say, lead me on, lead me on, lead me where I never. I want to see all the survivors, hands up in the air from right here. Say, when I, hey, Father, carry me. You say, Father. Somebody say, when I come to thee, Father, carry me. You say. Romeo and Burger, say for me. When it's dark.
When it's dark and night.
What are 3 years? What are 2 years?
I will lift my eyes to thy ears.
From for me and say, lead me.
Shine, lead me on.
Lead me, oh, lead me.
I can't do it without you. I can't do it without you. I can't be global without you. Everybody put your hands up, say, when I come to
the end of myself.
You say,
Father.
Comes from the Lord,
come now, come now.
One who made heaven and earth.
Say your bones, yes, bones, bones.
You're stronger than any other.
One thing,
one thing that I desire of you, that I may dwell here with you for
and ever.
Everybody, jump with me like this, jump with me like this. Bones, bones. Shut up, shut up. Watching across the world, this is reggae music. This is Jamaica. Ready, ready, say.
When I come to the end of myself,
Father, carry me. I love you. I need you.
I know.
You say, when I come to
the end of myself.
Father, Mr. Levy, come here 1 second, sir. 1 second, sir. Could you just come here 1 minute? Because we know we have a lot of persons watching online from across the world. And they have never... So, for those who are here and are watching, I want Mr. Levy today. Bring one up, brother. My first tour in the U.S., I went there and said, you know, in my ignorance, I want the whole church to skank. And, sir, I had no idea that in America, skank different from, skank have a different meaning than in Jamaica. So when I said church, skank, the whole church went cold because skank means. So I want Mr. Levy, sir, you want them to come up and help scan, sir, help. So can you come up and help Mr. Levy? So we're gonna hold on, Mr. Levy going for them. Okay, yes. So in Jamaica, for those who are watching, skank is a dance. It's a dance move, right? So before we go to the next song, I want everybody to come up and so it is S-K-A-N-K. It's not skank. It's skank. Yeah, 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 yeah. So come up stage. Come up on the stage. Come up on the stage. Come up on the stage. We want everybody to see you guys. Ready? Ready? Ready, Chad, ready. So this is how you skank. Ready. Your heels, yeah. Watch me, Sal. Step. And it's the simpler version. Now somebody put your hands on this for me. Say when I come, say
when I come.
Look at this. Look at this. Watch me, right here, watch here. When right here. Heels, 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 yeah, heels. You got it, you got it, you got it, you got it, you got it. One more time, put your foot, chorus, say, when I come to One more time, say. Somebody shout hallelujah. Happy 65 years. Make people know, I want to sound excited. Happy 65 Jamaica Brothers Group. All right, so I was going to do one song, but you know what? I can keep it moving. Skip that one for me, bro. Skip those two and go to the... That's enough for me. Let's dance for the next few minutes. Yeah. There is always somebody, but really, Trisha, well, they try to stop and block your progress most of the time. The main things they say, can't miss a friend then. Put it up on your chest, I mean, and say, I got Jesus. Say, I got Jesus. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm blessed. Jamie, blessed. All right, are you ready? Are you ready? Let's go. Hands up like this. There is so many times when I never have a dime. My Savior, hear my plea. He's mine. When you over yourself, dig me up. Put the fans up, 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 put the fans up.
Double JB. Don't you trouble. What? Say, Zion. What? Bass, that's the bass line. Show it. Ah. Done. You make me. And we guys make some noise for the band. Make some noise for the band, no man. I'm sitting in this place. It's God's goodness, God's grace. Some people who shouldn't, but you're still here. Who couldn't, wouldn't. Where are the survivors? Where you there? I guess that's a pull up. Look on your neighbor for me and tell him, hey, me no know where you are carry, but I know yes, so you stop. Say, greater is ahead. No, look in them face and say, got you. Hold on upon your neighbor and tell him, got you. Got you. Let's go. Say, you're my creator. God, you know my sign. You say, my season. So I will seek you. Seek you. God bless you. I love you guys. You're my show. No, let's go. Put your fans up one more time. You say, you make me. Hold on. I'm going to give a shameless plug. Dana, I love you. July 1st is my album launch that people have been waiting on for over 5 years. And I'm going to be coming to Mr. Levy. Hello. Because if there's Dana, you know, if there's anything Kevin doing, JB is always a part of it. Always. No matter what, if you can, if sometimes they can't provide the cash and they provide the kind. When we're doing the feeding thing done by Sav, they committed to 1.5 mil in food. We're still talking about that, Zane, back here, yeah. But when they can't provide cash, and I hope some people know that who seeking sponsorship, that sometimes the season rough and don't come to people for money every time. Come for partnership, and if they can't supply the cash, then them supply kind, simple. But part best dress chicken. So play the track one more time and let's wrap this up. Mr. Levy, God bless you. God bless you. Sir, respect. Somebody put your hands up in the air one more time. July 1, lock it in your calendar. Somebody shout hallelujah. Look where you brought them from, Jesus. You are the guidance. You are the guidance, Jesus. You are the guidance. Can't do without you. Jesus. I love you. Ready. Say, show my tree. Lord, you know my times. Woo! Seasons of rage. Hey! My seasons are. God bless you guys. You say, so I will.
Jamaica. Bless you guys. Ready, ready, ready. God bless you. You said,
you make me strong.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Thank you.
You make me
service. It has been our absolute pleasure to have you here with us. We hope that you'll have an amazing year. This is the start of our financial year, isn't it, Sheldon?
Yes, it is. A year full of blessings, promises.
Right. That's right.
And
expansion.
Both
in Jesus' name. Have a great evening, everybody. Make sure you get some of our delicious chicken before you go. Signing out.
If it's not